is a welterweight matchup between Damian Maya and Santiago Ponzinibbio.
Ready.
His hands look good. A lot of volume, a lot of accuracy tonight.
He's doing a great job being accurate. He's also very fast. Look at the hands he needs, right? Look at how he turned his hip into that leg kick.
That's a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice escape landed by the count.
And a nice job at least staying upright on that.
Big ball.
Have now landed for the forever busy Santiago Ponzinibbio. Checks the leg kick. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more of that coming.
Boxing. Boxing. Boxing.
And they separate. Under 2 minutes now to go. Gets tagged with a kick now. Let's see if he can wrap. Just misses without one. Well, collar tie. Wow.
You're good here, bro. Stay safe. Be smart.
They'll engage in a single collar tie. Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue.
Left hand punch to the clinch.
Maya gets caught with that punch. He's treading water now. Got to find a way to move those feet. 30 seconds now to go on the round. Maya gets touched by that move there. Now from that previous round, and he really kept finding a home for those kicks.
Yeah, and why would you change it? If your opponent is not going to check, if he's going to stand there and he's not on his toes.
All right, second round now underway. I'm no analyst, but a little bit of a feeling out process there.
And that's a part of being in the octagon.
Shots, you hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand? Because eventually you're gonna have to put something on your opponent that's gonna really make him pause. I believe the jab is working so well, if he drops a big right hand after, he may be able to finish.
Strikes have landed for Santiago Ponzinibbio. And connecting on a pretty good clip as well. 55% the accuracy rate against Damian Maya.
He's cutting down the side. Beautiful leg kick.
now to go in round two. Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found the rhythm and found his striking range. Scary proposition for the opponent now. Here is round two. Takedown defense holds up. 90 seconds now to go on the round.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Ponzinibbio's uppercut is blocked. Big shots being landed on both sides here. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. And now he's got that Thai clinch. We'll see what he can do with it. Well, if you like Muay Thai striking, this might be your moment in this fight as he gets the title.
This is a massive moment for this fighter. He is a great Muay Thai fighter. Look for him to go knees.
Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Both fighters here continuing to try to get a more dominant position in the clinch. Get fatigued in the process, I would think. So we now look back at some of the action from that previous round, DC. A lot of good highlights on both sides.
I mean, a lot of good highlights from both competitors. They both should be very proud.
All right, so another round is now underway. Pretty good action over the previous 10 minutes. Your thoughts on what we've seen?
Both of the guys really picked up on the action. Put their foot in the gas.
Job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block a shot that's incoming.
Well, that's a beautiful kick right there. I don't know if you've ever been kicked by a mule. It'll probably feel something like that.
It has to. This guy's.
That's as good punch as he throws.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 34 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout, Santiago Chichibola Ponzinibbio.